Well, welcome to the Beyond Cinema and Bio.com studio up here at TIFF. Damon Herriman, Josh Lawson, TJ Power. Firstly, congratulations, mate, having your feature directorial debut end up at one of the best festivals on the planet. Must be a pretty rewarding feeling.
Yeah, it's incredible. It's awesome to be here. We're just so excited.
And you get to hang out with these guys in a more social
setting.
Yeah,
so it's not all
this
good.
Yeah,
I mean, you can't have everything.
Some compromises.
No, it's awesome. It makes it so much sweeter that we get to come and enjoy it together. I only wish that everyone could be here, but it's such a massive cast, and of course it's...
Well, you mean everyone from the cast, not everyone.
Also, not every
from
person.
The world.
No, no.
Right,
no.
I was going to say, that's impossible.
Right. But that's right, everyone from the cast, but it's such a big cast, and everyone's working. So I got the only two unemployed.
That's great.
And I haven't seen the film. You've seen it, I believe.
I've seen it a thousand times.
But so I'm kind of stoked to actually see it for the first time at something as amazing as Toronto Film Festival. It's pretty cool.
Very cool. And in terms of, like, obviously these guys have been working internationally for a while. Some of the faces in the film are pretty much very kind of like well-known Australian actors as well.
Yeah.
People have been involved in Aussie TV and things like that for years. Why did you choose to kind of go back to Oz and shoot this? Was it because that's where your support system is?
Yeah. That definitely was a big part of it. Yeah, you're right. A lot of my connections were there, and even though I've been, knocking over some dominoes in the States for a while now, it didn't quite have that base that I felt I had in Australia. And on top of which, there was a bit of a sentimental, reason for doing it there. You know, Damon, read the first draft, probably 8 years ago, and we always talked about doing it in Australia for a lot of reasons, and one of them is, it's the sort of film that should be made in Australia but doesn't often get made in Australia. We don't tend to tonally... make films that tonally sit in this place, even though we should. It's a little riskier, it's a little more adult, and it's a comedy that isn't so broad, and Aussie films often go a bit broad. So, we thought that it was good for the industry to do a sort of project like that. It doesn't mean it was easy to get made there. Because it was tonally tricky, because the subject matter was a bit risque, it was tough to get funding. But 8 years on, we finally... kicked that goal there. Yeah.
So was this the only kind of passion project that you were working on the side in terms of your own writing?
I did shorts along the way.
Yeah,
made some short films and did some sketch stuff for Funny or Die along the way. But in terms of features,
wasn't this kind of like some skits as well along the way?
Well, not really. I mean, there was one. The role play story was, if you see the film, there's sort of five couples.
Yeah.
The one Damon's in the role play one. Had an early incarnation as a... Well, I'd written them all as shorts, but I'd actually filmed a version of that as a development piece. So it wasn't really ever intended to be a short. It was more that I'd shot it as a short as a way of ironing out the creases in the script and to see how we might shoot it if we eventually got to the stage that we are now at.
A lot of actors obviously trying to, also taking matters into their own hands, producing their own stuff, writing their own stuff on the side. You guys, have you been sitting on, because this is a film about passion, so you guys have a passion project on the side that you guys have been working on as well?
Yeah.
TJ?
Yeah, absolutely.
Can't just,
yeah, exactly. I'm working on a feature film at the moment. Apart from that, I just do write a lot of music and stuff too, so that's what I do on that.
So some of the Sapphires storyline is not too far from home in that regard?
Yeah, I was in the Sapphires.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, obviously don't you do homework.
Just a lucky coincidence. Yeah.
See what credit of mine is going to be.
This should be interesting.
Nothing. Okay.
We can justify
it. Yeah, sorry, I'm about to do the... it's a bit more justified in October, actually, last season, which is going to be fun. I've sort of made a few shorts and stuff over the years, not for a while, but I've got some of those unfinished feature scripts that I hopefully will get to finish off one of these days.
I think it's in a way, you'd be foolish not to explore that sort of thing as an actor. I mean... It's so, with so much competition now and so many avenues that you can get projects up, like, let's not, not the least of which is the internet. So a free, the internet, I'll have to talk about it later. you can literally shoot something and put it up for anyone to see. I mean, you don't have to go through a network system if you don't want to anymore. And hopefully, if you do enough internet stuff, you can get, So there's really no excuse anymore not to make something. And I think a lot of actors are going that path.
And Damon, you splitting your time between Oz and the US, working on films like J. Edgar and stuff like that as well. What kind of has that opened up your horizons in a different way? Has that changed the way you work, being exposed to all these different people? But are you in the new? You just worked with another first-time director, right, Mr. Rusty?
I did. Yes. Yeah. I just have a small role in that, but that was great, actually. I play a priest in that, and it was just a two-hander with Russell. So that was a fascinating experience to get to be working with him, and he's a brilliant actor. You know, looking in an actor's eyes who you've normally just seen on the screen, you're actually now in a scene with them, was pretty cool. But at the same time, knowing they're looking at you as a director as well as the other actor in the scene. And he did an amazing job in both roles.
You worked as like two of the most incredible directors, Clint Eastwood and me. And, do you know what I mean?
Sorry, I thought of a joke earlier. I wasn't laughing.
No, I didn't. Yes, I am.
Yeah, that's right. In terms of opening up opportunities, certainly working here has opened up opportunities at home, which has been great. I think until I first came here, I was just playing nerdy best friends at home, and I couldn't sort of play anyone who was in any way rough around the edges or a bad guy or crazy guy, and
or even I normal.
Only,
or you even know normal. What I mean? Like it's sort of, that's what I loved about you in this in right. Little Death is it was like Dan, the character you played, is just like a regular guy right. Who obviously got, you know, the story sort of spins out of control, but what. Damon's such an incredible character actor that it's easy to put him in those extreme characters, but what he does just as well is to find your humanity in the most regular, normal things.
It was certainly great to get to play the role of Dan because, yeah, I have often played those extreme characters in one way or the other, and this was, apart from his kind of, the fact that he's deluded and obsessive, he is a kind of just the guy next door,
yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
The guy in the next door garage.
Yes, that's right. That's right.
So, talk about two different kind of first-time directing experiences. Russell Crowe, Josh. Josh was the scarier of the two, I'm sure.
Terrifying.
I'm sure the budgets weren't the same. Right?
Is that also? Did you guys know each other before? Was this a case where? Yeah. So this. Yeah.
We've known each other for a long time, and yeah, I mean, this as Josh mentioned before, this script had been in our lives for a long time, pretty much since Josh first wrote it. I read it and I said at the time, this is one of the best scripts I've ever read. This is because the script is amazing, and you know, it just got better and better over the years, and I refused to believe that this film wasn't going to get made. It wasn't always necessarily the case that I was going to be in it. I was hoping I would, but there were certainly times, as Josh mentioned, that it was really hard to get funding, and there was one particular time I remember Josh going, this is it, I'm over it, I can't. We're coming up against so many brick walls trying to get it made, and he said, I'm going to actually shelve it. And that was devastating because I thought, you can't, this is too good. And so now when I, you know, the film not only being made but getting into a festival like Toronto, you go, wow, that really was worth the perseverance, you know, on Josh's part. Yeah.
Was that also because you wanted to hold on to, like, directing and being in it and producing it?
Well, yeah, I did. And and particularly the longer that it was, the longer I held on to it, the more I wanted to be the director because I was just living with it for so long.
Yeah.
You know, early on, had they the green lit it in the first year or two, I might have let go of it, actually. But after 4 years, I was like, no way. Like, now I've shot this movie in my head a million times. I'm not going to let anyone take it. So, you know, lots of sort of happy accidents along the way because, ultimately I was the right person to direct it because I knew the character so intimately. And, like I said, over the 8 years, I knew what it needed to look like. And so because it was only a 20-day shoot and everyone had to work so fast, nothing was kind of, in terms of, you know, setting up shots and stuff, nothing was improvised. Simon Chapman, the DP, and I came in with a really specific plan, and we were able to get a lot done over the short period.
TJ, just speaking quickly to your character, having to do the sign language in this film, I know you had to learn a little bit of that.
A little bit. I learned.
You learned it.
I just, on the plane over here, actually, I was there was no, you know, movies to watch, so I got out the computer and started to look at the videos that I'd taken from the lessons I had. I had four lessons with a guy in Sydney, and I was looking at the first lesson, and he came to my house the first day. I walked in the door and didn't speak to me. He could speak, but also knew sign language. And so I just had to kind of get straight in there. And then I looked at the, and I was kind of very slow. And then I looked at the fourth time we met, and I was watching, going, "What am I saying?" I had, like, I was just talking fluently with him and just having conversations.
Like TJ's audition. I mean, that's, you know, learning sign language. He learned sign language for his audition for this,
right? Which is, and so I didn't know TJ prior to this, and when I saw TJ's audition, I was like, "Holy shit! This, we found a deaf actor. This is unbelievable." I had no idea that he wasn't deaf, and he just learned enough for the audition. And then I was like, okay, well, I mean, a monumental task to, because it's a dialogue heavy scene, you know, even sign language. But TJ then learned, I mean, basically enough sign language, which is most of it, to not only be able to do the dialogue, but then to be able to improvise, you
know, in sign language.
In sign language.
Well, I was lucky though, because Aaron James, who plays Monica in the film, we're friends from a long time ago. So I got this audition, and I was like, Aaron, I have to learn sign language for this. Can you help me out? She's like, yeah, great. Mm. And a couple of weeks later, she got the audition too, and we auditioned together. It was fantastic.
Yeah, it was really great.
Yeah.
So that's opened up a whole new kind of world for you.
Yeah, well,
it's deaf roles. He's only doing deaf roles now.
So many times you're in a crowded room or something, and you see something funny, and you want to kind of talk to someone, but you can't really say it. You're like, wish you knew sign language. So many opportunities. Yeah.
Very cool. So guys, firstly, just, I mean, again, congratulations for being here, having this film, seeing this dream come through to realization. Pleasure having a chat with you.
Cheers, mate.
Thank you very much.
And